Happy day eight of our No Nonsense November. Sharon Hornell from here again with the giant head. Sorry. We're going to talk about our tool of the day today is mastermind. Now, I separated the words master and mind specifically. I learned about this concept through Napoleon Hill. And of course, the most famous version of his discussion and where he teaches the Mastermind Alliance is in the 1937 Bible of Personal Development, is what I call it, Think and Grow Rich. Now, prior to that, he actually wrote about this mastermind philosophy, and it evolved over the years from 1928 on and became part of his major body of work that has contributed to every personal development training, topic, course, coaching program from that point on. And he talked about something called a mastermind alliance, and it was the coordination of knowledge, his definition of mastermind, the coordination of knowledge and effort between two or more people who work towards a definite purpose in the spirit of harmony. Now, there's a lot of key words in there that are really important. Spirit of harmony. Whenever you're on a mastermind group, if it's a physical group of individuals coming together, the most important thing is to create harmony among those so that when two people come together, and what he believed is when two people come together and exchange ideas and knowledge and wisdom, a third type mind is created. And he called that the mastermind. So it's like synergy. The sum of the parts is greater than the individual parts taken than the individual parts. Hello. So mastermind, joining forces with other human beings, becomes exponentially powerful because everybody can learn from everybody else. Now, the cool thing that I liked about Napoleon Hill and why I chose this background is because he talked about you can have a physical mastermind, and those have been really popular. There's whole companies that have been created and software programs and actually very big multi-million dollar businesses that have been built around this single idea of the mastermind, bringing people from different backgrounds together and having them help one another. It's kind of like being mentor-mentee, but it's bigger and broader than a mentor and mentee relationships. It's more of, I guess it's valuing all human beings equally and in a spirit of cooperation and harmony, coming together to help one another along. So you can have people from different industries, different backgrounds, different ages, different demographics, whatever, coming together and helping everyone to grow and expand and be more successful at whatever it is that they want to achieve or do or be or have in their life. I've been on several masterminds, lots of masterminds. I've led mastermind groups. I've been a part of them. And I also have, and this might be too woo-woo for some people, but I have my own mastermind board of directors. And it's, some people are living, some people are dead. It's just in my imagination, in my mind, where I will go and tap into the wisdom and the knowledge in my mind of actually interacting and be in a mastermind type relationship with different people. My dad, who has passed away 5 years ago now, is on my mastermind team. My Abraham Lincoln, Ben Franklin, and I could name a bunch, but dead people, but there's also live people that I've never met that are on my mastermind team in my, or my mastermind alliance or team, whatever you want to call it, that I tap into. Louise Hay, Oprah Winfrey, Tony Robbins, people that for some reason or another, I would want to tap into part of their genius, not their whole personality, their whole genius, their whole wisdom, but pieces and components that I see in them that and values and characteristics I see in them that I want to cultivate and build up in myself. That's the mastermind alliance to me. And I'd say there's between 50 and 100 people on my overall mastermind alliance team, but it changes all the time. When I go to my mastermind, which I actually did this exercise this morning because I haven't done it for a while and I forget how powerful it is. But with all of the things going on in the United States right now, I wanted to tap into higher wisdom, my higher power, and say, okay, what does this mean to me? Guys, what does this mean to me? So when I first woke up this morning, instead of doing my normal meditation, I did a mastermind exercise. I hopped into my mastermind group and I've got a It's fun to embellish and create a vision for yourself. I have a giant round table like King Arthur would have, and it expands and contracts based on how many people are hanging out at the particular mastermind. This morning there were 14. I had just 14 people at my mastermind group, and we were talking and discussing the impact of what's going on in the world and in America, and how it how I should interpret it, how I should have it impact me, what's a waste of energy and resources in my own life, and what's a what I should keep doing. And of course, I got the go ahead to keep doing what I'm doing, keep sharing what I'm sharing, keep sharing with people the things that I've learned and that have helped me to achieve the level of success that I want in my life. And that I'm doing through the No Nonsense November, this particular thing. And then December 1st, we're going to start the next 30-day free Get Up and Go challenge, so that we know what to do every single day of our life, so that we have a framework to follow that will guarantee we have better results after any change or challenge than before we face that, no matter what that change or challenge is. Oh my gosh, we've all lived so far through COVID-19, a pandemic. I never thought in my lifetime that we would actually experience a pandemic. And if we can do that, we can live and do anything. So normally when I'm doing live people in-person masterminds or on those, I like to have it be between 5 and 7 people. Once you get over that, I mean, you can do 10, but it gets a little cumbersome because you're trying to coordinate 10 busy human beings' schedules now and finding a time and a place when everybody can make sure they get to share what's going on with them and ask questions and ask for help and feedback to really help them move in the direction of their goals and objectives. It's so powerful. But again, the bigger the group, the harder it is. I've actually been in some masterminds that have they're more of a group coaching program than they really are a mastermind. They're called a mastermind because people think that that sounds hot right now, but they're really operated like a group coaching program. Not the same. There's benefits in group coaching programs, but it's not the same as a real live. We are synergistically working together to improve all of our situations as a mastermind group or a mastermind alliance, in my opinion, should be done. Again, my opinion. I would love to know your experience with masterminds. Have you been in them? Have you found them positive experiences or negative? What were some of the details of them? And secretly, I want to know, does anybody else have their own imagination, visioning, mastermind alliance or group that they call upon? I call mine my board of directors, because I think in my life, I need some people to keep me going in the right direction. And I need a board of directors to bounce ideas off of every once in a while. And especially during COVID, It's not possible. Yeah, we have technology where we can tap into people and we can call them, and we've always been able to call them, of course, if they're living. But even with the ability to do that, sometimes we need people with experience and skills in other areas than those that we have personal direct access to or can communicate with and actually bounce ideas off of. And so I'm curious if anyone else has their own mastermind board of directors or mastermind alliance or mastermind team, mastermind, I don't know, whatever you want to call them, badass supporters. I think that badass has become a really popular buzzword right now. I don't really love it. I don't like it. I mean, I think you just be who you are, and that makes it all work out. Okay. That's it. That's our tool for today, the mastermind tool. Again, I'll be with you tomorrow with another tool, a tool a day for our No Nonsense November sharing. And if there's one that you would like to know about, if you have a question about a tool and you want to know if I've ever used it, ask in the comments below. Otherwise, I'll be with you tomorrow. Have an awesome day. Bye.